Hello, I'm Jen Grice, author of the book You Can Survive Divorce. I'm a divorce mentor and empowerment coach, guiding women to surviving and thriving after divorce. You find out more about this ministry and my book at jengrice.com. Also, get all the resources, tools, and encouragement you need to get through this foreign territory we call divorce here and on my website. We're glad to have you along on this journey. So I often get asked, am I a narcissist magnet or a toxic person magnet or any of those things? Am I drawn to them? Are they drawn to me? And that kind of thing. So since my encounter with which was probably a narcissist, which I talked about in one of my last videos, I started to wonder if I was a narcissist magnet myself. So I thought I'd talk about it today. Many people in this world can be narcissistic in nature, even if they don't have narcissistic personality disorder, which is a mental disorder under the cluster B personality disorders. Narcissists lack empathy for other people, are very self-centered and rather entitled, and use manipulation to control people. Narcissistic personality disorder is a much more extreme version, which includes other characteristics as well. But today we're just going to talk about selfish, entitled people who lack empathy and are manipulative, and why we seem to attract them. First, narcissists are always looking for caretakers. They don't want to take care of themselves, so they find someone who's willing to do the work for them. When you're wondering if somebody is a narcissist, the signs you need to look for are, do they reciprocate anything that you do for them, appreciate it? Do they always have an excuse why they can't? Example, I have to work, I don't like hospitals. Who does like hospitals? But that doesn't mean we don't go there if someone we love is also there. Better yet, look at how they treat their mom or grandparents or somebody else who's physically sick. Do they really care? Do they really take the time to help, to have consideration, to go out of their way? You know, ask the parent or the patient how they feel that that person is treating them. Since narcissists lack empathy, you need to see how they really feel about someone who can't do anything for them. If they do something and it's not about their image or for show, but because they really care in their heart and want to help. This is how you can tell the difference between a narcissist and another person, because a narcissist really doesn't care. They're always about their image. So on to the second one. Narcissists are very self-centered and feel entitled to the best treatment. Look at the situation when life is not fair for the narcissist. Do they try to make it easier for themselves? Do they ask others to try to enable them to make it easier for them? Do they whine and cry and expect others to cater to them? Are you enabling by allowing the narcissist to have more than their share? Because if you're a giving person and you're willing to give more and not expect fairness and equality, they will certainly take it. And when you take less and get less, you won't be served in return. Does the people in your life act entitled to everything that is yours? Or are you empowered to have your fair share? Not meaning that you're a narcissist because you ask for equality. You're asking for what's rightfully yours as a human being, just like anybody else. If the narcissist or any other person is deserving, that means you are too. So what I'm saying is don't put yourself last all the time. This may upset other people in your life, but that's okay because their upset is their problem, not your problem. It just means you won't put up with narcissistic behavior and you expect to get your fair share. Narcissists and toxic people won't like this, so you won't be attracted to him or her any longer. I like the analogy of putting on your own oxygen mask on a plane. Do you put on your own oxygen mask and then help the person next to you, like they instruct you to do? Or do you allow someone else to grab and take all the oxygen, leaving you with none? A narcissist would totally grab all the masks, thinking he's more valuable and entitled to it all, or expect you to put on the mask on him first rather than try to save yourself. When you see this type of behavior going on, it's time to walk away, when you know for the rest of your life you'll be giving up anything you need for yourself. Relationships are about empowering and encouraging others and serving each other and doing for other people. A narcissist gets in a relationship to take, not to give. And if you get in a relationship with a narcissist taking and you're always giving, you're going to be at a deficit. There's nothing left to give. And you find out no matter how sick you are, you'll be dealing with illness on your own. You will have nobody to take care of you. This is when I knew that I couldn't stay married, when I knew that my medical disorders, I have a brain herniation and lupus. I found out different years apart, and I wasn't enough. I wasn't important enough to get any attention when these things were going on. I wasn't allowed to be upset or worried about my future. Because that made me selfish in, you know, somebody else's mind. My job was to keep serving my family and expect nothing in return. And this is a big red flag that you are dealing with a narcissist and you're putting up with being treated that way. So lastly, narcissists are manipulative. They use words, anger, and other emotions to control you. You may say, it hurts my feelings when you do, in whatever, the healthy way of talking to somebody. And his reaction will be to attack you and tell you that you are wrong. And when you want to do something for yourself, he'll say, we don't have the money, or I already made plans for us to do blank, blank, blank. He doesn't want you to do anything for yourself, especially without him, because he's entitled to everything that you have and more. He wants to be the center of attention, and that entitlement causes him to just be served rather than serving you and not thinking about you and your needs. Also, part of narcissists being manipulative, they sabotage any growth you may be doing, like getting a better job or going to school. He can't stand you doing better because you might leave him, so he'll talk you into spending more time with him rather than studying or working, often using guilt trips to make you feel bad for doing something for yourself, working or studying. He may even start a fight to get your attention away from those things, which is another big red flag to run. This person is selfish and doesn't care about you or you bettering yourself or your future. I mean, what if something did happen to him and he was to die and left you to be dependent on him? That's just very selfish. So, are you a narcissist magnet? Let me know how you're working on these qualities that make you a good person, but attract you to the wrong type of partner. I hope this was encouraging and empowering for you. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. If you like this type of video and want to see more, I'm working on creating a Strong Woman After Divorce online course, and I'm hoping to have that completed by this fall, 2019. Is something that would interest you, please let me know. And I hope to see you in the next video. God bless.